Hello there, I'm speaking to you from Kirkcaldy. All along our high street used to be the marketplace, and on either side of the street were stalls and residential buildings. Behind that were long rig gardens fanning outwards. In one of those gardens is where Adam Smith, the economist, grew up with his mother, and that garden is still open today. Kirkcaldy was marking 300 years of the birth of Adam Smith, who wrote The Wealth of Nations, the famous economic treatise. There were people here from all over the world taking part in that. I became involved modestly by being the minister who reenacted the baptism of Adam Smith in the Old Kirk. And I used the silverware that would have been used for him. His name is recorded in the register. Afterwards, I got on a carriage ride with some others through Kirkcaldy, pulled by two horses. I celebrate that event. I celebrate other things as well. I celebrate the whole season that I had as a volunteer guide in Hopetoun House, which I have enjoyed tremendously, especially meeting people from other countries. Another achievement has been to continue being a walker, and I have now completed this year the walk from Dunbar to North Berwick to Edinburgh and out to Falkirk, which consists of more than half of the John Muir Way across the countryside. So I'm making my way to Helensburgh, but it's getting too dark to do that just now, so that will wait for next year. I hope that you have had a lot of things to celebrate and enjoy as well. However, it's very hard at this time. Those of you who have known me from the church know that as soon as we get into Advent, I deliberately try to hold us back from the excesses of Christmas, knowing the truth is that all is not well in our world, and probably not all that well in our own towns and in our own lives either. We try to put that to the side. The cry of the suffering world comes in the hymn, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel. We sing that very solemnly and with great feeling as we light a candle. Sadly, at the moment, the cry of the suffering people is for the people of Israel, but also for the people of Palestine, and for the people in other troubled places. During this whole last year, the flag of Ukraine has been flying from the war memorial here in Kirkcaldy, and we remember that situation as well as many others, both national, international, and personal. So we approach Christmas with heavy hearts, as well as with our hopes and with our joys. Christmas in Bethlehem is going to be a very different affair this year, as we will see on the news. I always enjoy making the big declaration, the people who have walked in darkness have seen a great light, and I hope that even in the darkness, there are many things that light up our life and light up our world that give us hope so that we do not give in and surrender to darkness and death, but we work for life. We celebrate the coming of the Christ child on Christmas Day, which is fast approaching now, and we come with the thoughts of the context of Christmas. Remember, the day after Christmas and the day following that are the Feast of St. Stephen, the first Christian martyr, and the Massacre of the Innocents. How relevant are these thoughts for all of us today? We hold that careful balance, but trusting and believing that the light shines even through all of that, that God is with us in that suffering and devastation and evil, and that good will pertain and come through. O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see you lie. Above your deep and dreamless sleep, The silent stars go by, yet in your streets is shining the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in you tonight. O morning stars, together proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. For Christ is born of Mary, and gathered all above. While mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wandering love. And we trust and believe that there are angels looking after us, guiding us, correcting us, channeling our energies, forgiving us, and giving us hope. I sing there of men because that's what we all learned, but the hymn, of course, should be inclusive and say men and women, if you can find the right word to say that at the right time. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and always. Amen. Thank you for keeping in touch with me.